والله يدعو إلى دار السلام ويهدي من يشاء إلى صراط مستقيم.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبيه مصطفاه. Dear brothers and sisters, Abu Huraira رضي الله تعالى عنه أرضاه narrated that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إن أول ما يحاسب به العبد من عمله يوم القيامة صلاته. That the very first thing that the servant of Allah will be questioned about amongst his actions is a salah. And that shows the importance and the significance of the prayer as an act of worship. So that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says that if the salah was perfect and done properly, فَقَدْ أَفْلَحَ وَنَجَحَ, that the servant of Allah on that day will prosper and will be successful. If there was any defect or shortcoming in his prayer, Allah the Almighty will say to his angels, of course, أُنظُرُوا أَحَلِّ عَبِدِي مِن تَطَوَّعَ, examine the record of my servant. If he has any tatawwa, any voluntary act of worship, so that if he had any, they would take from at-tatawwa and to complete and make up any deficiency that took place in the fard or the mandatory salah. And accordingly, every act of worship will be dealt with likewise. From that, we understand that, yes, the fard, the mandatory prayers, are just 5 times a day. The fajr, dhuhr, asr, maghrib, and isha. However, offering an-nawafil or at-tatawwa is also of a great importance to make up any deficiency, because shortcomings, drawbacks, and deficiency is the quality of a human being, humankind. And that's why it's very important to try to make up as much as we can of nawafil to complete any deficiency that would take place in our fard prayers. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says in a sound hadith that Allah the Almighty says, ما تقرب إلي عبدي بشيء أحب إلي مما افترضته عليه. That means, my servant does not draw close to me with anything better than what I have enjoined upon him, the fard. But my servant will continue to draw near me through an-nawafil, the voluntary acts of worship, حتى أحبه, till I love him. فإذا أحببته, and if I love him, Allah the Almighty is saying, I will be his hearing with which he hears. I will be his seeing, his sight, which he sees with. I will be his hand, which he strikes with. I will be his legs, which he walks with. And, وَلَئِن سَأَلَنِي لَأُعْطِيَنَّ, and if he ever asks from me, I will give him. وَلَئِن اسْتَعَاذَنِي لَأُعِيذَنَّ, and if he ever seeks refuge and protection with me, I shall give him refuge and protection. So, an-nawafil is a very important practice. The Prophet ﷺ used to have certain nawafil, voluntary prayers, which he used to observe regularly. Just a few times, or when he was traveling, he might have missed. Otherwise, he would observe regularly. Those are known as as-sunan al-rawatib, or the confirmed sunan. In one sound hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says that one who regularly observes the prayer of 12 rak'ahs during the day and the night, the voluntary prayers, an-nawafil, at-tatawwa, all of that is right. Whoever observes regularly praying 12 rak'ahs, thintay asharat rak'ah, each day and night, Allah will build a house for him in paradise. بَنَ اللَّهُ لَهُ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ, if you're having a trouble to rent an apartment or to own a house in this life, Allah is promising you to build a house for you in paradise by offering these 12 rak'ahs of an-nawafil. So what are they? Are you ready to count with me? I mean to keep in mind and heart. First, 4 rak'ahs before dhuhr, 2 at a time. 2 and 2. So each 2 rak'ahs with tashahud and taslim. four rak'ahs before offering salat of dhuhr. Sunnah mu'akkada. Confirmed sunnah that the Prophet ﷺ used to observe. And after dhuhr, he would offer two rak'ahs. So how many we got so far? Six. Four before dhuhr and two after dhuhr. Two rak'ahs after maghrib. You saw the confirmed sunnah. So far we got eight rak'ahs. Two after Isha, sunnah mu'akkada. Then we got 10. And two before Fajr, total is 12. Once again, two before Fajr, four before Dhuhr, two and two. Two rak'ahs after Dhuhr, two rak'ahs after Maghrib, two rak'ahs after Isha. These 12 rak'ahs are known as السنن الرواتب السنن المؤكدة or the confirmed sunnah of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Keep in mind that the most important of all are the two rak'ahs before Fajr. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to observe them regularly, whether prisoner, whether resident or traveling. Even if he would travel, he would still offer the two rak'ahs before Salatul Fajr. So, for praying them regularly, Allah will build a house for you in paradise. What about prayers before and after other fard prayers? These are known as al-nawafil or as-sunan, which are not confirmed by the meaning that the Prophet ﷺ used to do them sometimes, but not on regular basis. And he did not emphasize on their importance, like as-sunan al-rawatib or the confirmed sunan. So the Prophet ﷺ would sometimes pray four rak'ahs before Asr. And he said that you may pray two rak'ahs before Maghrib for whoever would like to do so, and two rak'ahs before Isha. These are the nawafil which are related to the fard prayers before and after each prayer. We discussed the confirmed ones and the other prayers which the Prophet ﷺ would do sometimes and said for whoever would like to offer them. For extra reward, of course, and definitely we're in need for every reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By praying so, we're trying to make up any deficiency that can happen in our fard performance. Now, come to another very, very important prayer, which is Salatul Watr. Salatul Watr, many of the scholars considered it a wajib, a mandatory prayer. Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal says that the person who does not pray Salatul Watr is an evil man. Imam Abu Hanifa, may Allah have mercy on him, said that Salatul Watr is a wajib. And that if the person did not get to pray Salatul Watr, he should make it up even next morning. Other scholars said that it is a confirmed sunnah, like any other confirmed sunnah, such as the two rak'ahs before Fajr or the four before Dhuhr, etc. In any case, why would you ignore Salatul Watr? While the Prophet ﷺ said to Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, as he says, أوصاني خليلي, my best friend, Abu Huraira is saying, my best friend advised me not to sleep before offering Salatul Watr. And the meaning of that is not you have to pray watr before you sleep. No, that you have to make sure that you pray watr and not miss it. But the person can pray Isha, then rest and pray either tahajjud, qiyamul layl, or just will be satisfied with salatul watr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the watr in the Quran. He took it as an oath, wash-shafi wal-watr fi surat al-fajr, because of its significance. Al-Watr is an Arabic word which literally means the odd number. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes anything in an odd number. So we seal our daily prayers, the day and the night, by an odd number prayer. That's why Salatul Watr can be offered by praying two rak'ahs, shafa, or even. Then making taslim after tashahud, then praying one rak'ah of al-watr. And in this one rak'ah, it's recommended after you rise up from ruku' to make dua while raising your hands. This dua in the sunnah is called qunut, to ask Allah, Allahumma ihdini fi man hadayt, wa'afini fi man 'afayt, wa tawallani fi man tawallayt. Concerning the beautiful supplications which we quoted throughout our program, I highly recommend for you to own and have a beautiful booklet which is named The Fortress of the Muslim. Get the Arabic and English version so that you can memorize it in Arabic. Supplicate with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially the verses and the supplications which Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in Arabic and know their meaning in English. Once again, it's called The Fortress or the Citadel of the Believer or of the Muslim. It's a beautiful book that compiles many of the very sound hadith and supplications to be recited during different occasions and amongst them during the Salah. Many people inquire about the night prayer or Salatu al-Tahajjud. Salatu al-Tahajjud is a beautiful prayer and it is the practice of the righteous believers that after Salatu al-Isha and at any time between Isha, after Isha until Fajr, a person may pray as many rak'ahs as he wishes, as many prayers as he can afford, as much as you can. Yet, Ummul Mu'mineen Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, narrated that the Prophet ﷺ used not to exceed 11 rak'ahs in any time, whether it's Ramadan or any other time. We're talking about the night prayer. 8 rak'ahs he would pray, 2 at a time, 2 by 2, 2 by 2. Since the Prophet ﷺ said, Salatul Layli Masna Masna. The best way and form to offer the night prayer or even the day prayer of Al Nawafil is to pray 2 at a time, 2 at a time. So pray 2, 2, 2, total is 8. Then you pray Shafa and what? This is one way. There are so many other ways. You can actually pray all the prayers together. Then by the end, make sure that you have an odd number prayer, which is al-watch. Do not limit yourself to a certain madhab, or certain school of thought. The most important thing is to offer a nawafil and pray as much as you can. This is an asset for you that would increase the balance of your good deeds and remove many of the mountains of faults and mistakes that we commit on daily basis. وَمَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي بِشَيْءٍ أَحَبَّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا افْتَرَضْتُهُ عَلَيْهِ وَلَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلِ حَتَّى أُحِبَّهُ. My servant will continue to draw near me by doing what? النوافل. Until I love him. And if Allah loves you, then you're truly the successful one. May Allah love all of us and accept from us our prayers and every act of worship we do. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.